I'm Pablo Modernel from Universidad de la República in Uruguay.
And I'm Caitlin Corrington. I'm from MindFuel here in Calgary, Canada.
We are in this great venue that is Banff and taking this transdisciplinary course and trying to bridge science and policy. And we developed a project around native grasslands conservation in South and North America. And some of the lessons that we've learned are that how language is important and how to have a common language and that we understand each other when we are talking about one topic. So I'm an agronomist and Caitlin works in education. Sometimes you have concepts that we have to really encounter the words and the meanings to understand each other where we work in research.
Mm-hmm. I think one of the most important reasons why this work is so critical is because as problems are becoming more complex and how the world is evolving, we see more and more how important it is to have sectors coming together to discuss global problems and to have collaboration across cultures and across borders, you know, especially with conservation concerns and climate change. So for us, this is really exciting to be having these conversations, doing this research and this work so that we can facilitate facing these global challenges.
Yeah, definitely. So problems are getting more and more complex. So that's why we need all this, let's say, rainbow of disciplines and also of cultural approaches. And having clear what's the objective that of what we want to work on, it's also one of the most important things we've learned in this seminar, that if we agree where we want to go, well, then we have to understand each other what we want to do and bridging these different disciplines and different sectors. That's what we think that sustainable development will be in the future.
Yeah, I know for myself and my work in education, I've learned a lot about the sorts of skills and communication that's important to face these challenges. And so I'm really excited to see how this work can translate into younger generations and bring this to youth, both in Canada, but in countries around the world as well.
Yeah, for me, it's a great opportunity because I work in academia and sometimes the academic world is disconnected from, let's say, real world and enterprises and the private sector. And this has been a great opportunity to reconnect to that and also to bridge to a large network of researchers, NGOs and private sector that is dealing with those problems daily. And so that gives me the opportunity to understand the real problems and also to work for those solutions from the research side.
Yeah. I think that's it.